So far, we've covered the AI fundamentals. That stuff won't change anytime soon. But with so much else about AI, things are changing fast. We'll cover three groups of trends to watch for: new deep learning models, new applications of these models, and AI safety considerations. First, new deep learning models. The leading AI companies will likely keep launching bigger and better models. Bigger means using larger networks and more parameters. That requires more compute power and more GPUs. Better is harder to define, but not impossible. For one, better means handling longer context windows. This improves model performance on longer text sequences. Better also means performing well on more tasks, especially ones that the model wasn't explicitly trained for. This is called zero-shot mode, because the model was given zero training shots at the task. While model performance is subjective, there's a growing body of standardized tests that evaluate these models, like the MMLU, which stands for Massive Multitask Language Understanding. This is like the SAT for LLMs. And of course, the question on everyone's mind is, how good will they get? Are we on track to reach the much-discussed artificial general intelligence, or AGI, milestone, meaning an AI model that can do any cognitive task? Most experts still see AGI as a distant possibility. In fact, some expect the current transformer pathway to eventually reach a dead end, requiring a return to first principles. And while bigger and better is indeed the trend, there is a parallel push for lighter-weight, more tailored models called SLMs for small language models. Building and applying cutting-edge generalist LLMs requires many costly GPUs, a scarce and often fought-over resource at many companies. Sometimes you simply don't need all-in-one functionality, and would prefer an SLM that can be trained for a narrower set of tasks and operated on smaller systems at a lower cost. The final trend in new deep learning models are the so-called multimodal models, models designed up front to work equally well with images and text. These combine the architectures that work well with text, like transformers, with ones that work well with images, like diffusion models. One example is OpenAI's Sora, called a diffusion transformer, which specializes in text-to-video, turning descriptions into vivid video scenes. Google's Gemini is another leading multimodal model family. Let's turn to the second group of trends, more applications of these models. In the big world of AI product development, relatively few people and companies are working on the underlying models, often called foundational models, like GPT and Gemini. Many are instead working on clever ways to apply these models, for example, by stringing together subsequent rounds of prompting. Want an AI model to write a newsletter? You could prompt it once and see what comes back. This is an example of zero-shot mode, since the model hasn't been explicitly trained to write newsletters on your topic. However, zero-shot results can usually be improved with more rounds of prompting. So, instead of a single prompt, you could ask the model to follow a procedure over a series of prompts. First, search the web for trends, then draft an outline, then give itself feedback on the outline, and so on. This is called chain of thought. Chain of thought broadens the types of tasks we can use LLMs for. Plus, by using APIs to connect with other models and third-party software products, AI models can orchestrate more than just text generation. This is how LLMs can help create smart assistants that manage your calendar and prioritize your inbox, for example. AI tools that can work toward tasks or goals in this way are often called AI agents, or agent workflows. This is also called agentic AI. And thanks to low-code tools like LangChain, even non-developers can now build their own LLM-based applications in this way. Another growing AI use case is for tough-to-crack research questions. For example, helping discover new drug therapies. In modern medicine, custom-built synthetic proteins can help deliver drugs in a targeted way. This itself isn't new. However, AI models are speeding up the delivery process. Bespoke deep learning models, like DeepMind's AlphaFold, can predict the 3D structure of a new protein in advance using its amino acid sequence, sort of like predicting a human face from the DNA. Some expect these tools to accelerate drug discovery timelines by 10 times. And 10 times breakthroughs might be possible in other research domains as well, like fusion power or room temperature semiconductors. Of course, while there is optimism, there are also concerns. This brings us to the last set of trends, those related to AI safety, or responsible AI. There is a range of concerns about these models. For one, accuracy. Model outputs are known to be factually wrong. Errant outputs are sometimes called hallucinations. Developers can improve accuracy via approaches like retrieval augmented generation, or RAG. Here, the model will fact-check its responses against additional source information, like real-time search results. Another concern is bias. Models will naturally reflect the biases, say political leanings, of their source data. Model developers are still exploring solutions here. One approach is what's called constitutional AI, where models are grounded in a set of principles that guide their behavior in gray zones. IP concerns are growing as well, particularly around the rights to use training data. The New York Times, for example, has sued OpenAI for using the Times' news content as training data. Artists have raised similar concerns about image models. If a model can scan my artwork and replicate my style, is that IP theft? Another concern is human misuse of AI. For example, using deepfaked audio or video to spread misinformation. And finally, perhaps the gravest but most distant set of concerns relates to machine misuse. AI agents going rogue and causing serious harm, say to our financial or communication systems. Far-fetched? Maybe.